Welcome to another episode of A Feminine Moment. I am Cherry Lynn, and I'm here with Dixie Andelin Forsythe, author of Fascinating Womanhood for the Timeless Woman.
Hi.
Dixie is also the daughter of Helen B. Andelin, who wrote the original Fascinating Womanhood. And today, we're excited to talk about one of the core Fascinating Womanhood principles, which is admiration. So Dixie, do you want to tell us? I know your book has a chapter on admiration, and Helen's book has a chapter on admiration. So this is obviously a very important subject, and we get a lot of questions about it. So you want to talk a little bit about the background?
In Fascinating Womanhood, a lot of times we get a lot of questions from ladies wanting to know about this or that in their marriage. And so many times it boils down to you can't change another person. And what we try to lean them towards is accepting a man at face value. And how you do that, one of the core ways of doing that is admiration. And it isn't just like it isn't only just you accept a person at face value and that's it. They all kind of merge one into the other. Admiration, acceptance, finding things to make him your hero, all those kinds of things. So when you admire a person, what it does, it's actually really good psychology. It helps you when you decide you're going to do this, is you become almost like a detective. Instead of looking for or noticing all the things he does that annoys you or that are wrong, because human beings are not perfect, and we all know that intellectually, but we too often don't allow for them to be human. And so when you admire a person, it almost seems kind of magical how people respond to it. I think most people, men and women, don't get enough sincere admiration. People looking at them and saying, I noticed the way you did that. That was really great. And say specifically what they did, whether it's they worked with their hands and made something or fixed something, or they thought of an idea or did something kind for another person. There are endless ways to admire, to look for ways to admire a person, because every person who is born has unique talents and strengths. If you, next time you go to a store and you see people wandering around the store, you can practice it by thinking, I wonder what their great talents are that may not be visible at all to you. So that's kind of where you can become kind of a detective. And as you do, as you admire sincerely something about another person, and let's focus on your husband, because we're building these lifelong love affairs with him. When you do that, it's amazing how that wall of reserve begins, they begin to trust you. A lot of times it's very slow, especially if there's a lot of hurt or things from their past that are in their lives. And they begin to trust you, and then they begin to allow themselves to be more vulnerable around you, which makes your relationship closer.
Now, let me ask you this. I know you said that every human, men and women, of course, we all love to be admired, but why is it especially important that men need to be admired?
Because men, that it's one of our differences. Even though we like to be admired, we, even more than that, more women want to be loved and told that they're loved, verbalized. But it makes them feel the best if they feel competent. Men have a driving desire to feel competent in what they do. And when you admire something about him, whether it's something that he had nothing to do with, like the color of his eyes or his love his hair or something that he was kind of born with, it makes him feel more competent, more relevant. Because, you know, men, my husband Bob always says, men can't have babies. They have to do something. And women take for granted, whether we have one or not, that we have this incredible, miraculous ability to produce another human being. Men don't have that. They never have had that. And so what is their core strength? What do they do in this world? They need to feel competent. And whether it's you admire his beautiful hands or the way he, like in my case, I admire, I've gotten to work with Bob for a few years now that you guys are grown at some of his clinics, and I see the way he interacts and deals with his patients. I have typed thousands of his reports. He's a neuropsychologist, for anyone who doesn't know. I have seen not only how good his reports are, But how he interacts with people, he treats all of his patients the same as if they were his one of his colleagues. A little while ago, I was with him, and we had a patient that was probably the dirtiest human being I have ever seen. I hope I didn't go when he walked in. He was so dirty. His fingernails were caked with dirt. He looked like he had not bathed in a year or two. His hair looked like he slept in the dust. He had this beard. He had the filthy clothes on. And when he walked in to the office, it was his turn for his evaluation. I didn't see Bob, but I could hear him. Hi, how are you doing? I'm Dr. Forsyth. And he shakes the guy's hand. And then I see that the door closes because they have to do this evaluation. And he treats people so good and so equal. And I've heard that's nothing. The most amazing story to me is I've had patients come in. They were really grumpy. And I'm just the secretary. So they'll be like kind of snarky and kind of snappy at me. I think, oh, I feel sorry for him. They have to go in there. And like within 10 minutes, I hear him laughing. I think, what did he do? So he has this ability with people that I never recognized. But I take every opportunity to tell him what I've seen because it's amazing to me. And you can do that with your husband, even if you don't get to work at all with him. You can notice how he is. Absolute importance of it being sincere. If you just say, you're a great guy, well, that sounds okay, but he might think, what do you want?
I think you bring up such a great point about it being sincere and genuine, because I see so many times some of the ladies that we have on our Facebook group, they come to the group and they ask questions and help, and that, you know, that's what we're there for. That's what the support
right.
system. And many times you hear the same story of, well, I've been telling him this, and I've been doing this, and I've been cooking for him and cleaning for him, and I've been
right.
almost like it's a checklist, and it's not working. And I think a lot of times, not every time, I know every case is really different, but a lot of times it has to do with it being genuine. Well, do you really genuinely admire him for those things, or is that just something that you're trying to do to change things?
And cooking for him and cleaning and all that is important. It's not like it's no big deal. But the lifeblood of your relationship with him is your understanding him, accepting him, and admiring him. What does this man do? Why did you fall in love with him? I hope it wasn't just because he was handsome. Because the people get older and that kind of fades, you know, in time. But it's a little too superficial. It's okay, but it's kind of superficial. But what do you love about this man? What are his qualities? How is he competent? The core things are understanding men, accepting him at face value. And you know what? It's free. It's so free. And you can do it, and you can be, you know, soon we're working on a love library, a love booklet that we're creating that has a lot of prompts in it. And it's really going to be neat because it's going to help you to be able to, you can open this up and it says, a great joke my husband told. And you can, there's all these prompts. There's also places for you to write the lovely things he said about you. But the love booklets up to now is just go out and get a blank booklet and write stuff in it. This way it has prompts like the first one is sort of like, where did you meet? What did you like about him? All these prompts. And so when you get one, you're going to be constantly looking for things that you can fill in. And it's going to naturally help you to watch him, almost like you're a detective solving a case, to find these things and treasure hunt for these things that are already there. That's why you fell in love with this man in the first place.
I love the idea of this love book library, because I think it's hard when you're used to, if you're someone out there that's trying to change your marriage and you're used to not admiring, it sounds so simple, but it's actually... it's hard, like you said, it's a treasure hunt sometimes to find those things. And I hear you say all the time how important it is to be grateful. And some of the things you're describing remind me of just simply being grateful every day, and not just for the things you have, but the things that you admire in your husband.
If I'm tempted to be a little negative, which doesn't happen almost never with Bob because he's so great, but what I have done in the past is sometimes I've imagined, how would I feel if this was his last day and he died. And how would I feel about him? Because when somebody dies, even if it's somebody we weren't terribly close to, we tend to remember all the positives. And I wish I had talked to them more.
I think about that all the time. To remember to kiss my husband goodbye, I think, what if this was the last? I know that sounds really...
I know, it kind of scares you, so you don't want to do it too often. But if you need to remind yourself ever to say, would I, you know, some people that say, that describe their husbands like, gosh, it sounds like a really horrible guy, think, would you be kind of relieved if he died, or would you be devastated? And if you would be, look for the positives in him, because most people, I mean, there's some exceptions to some people that are just really awful. But those aren't people we're talking about. Most people have qualities and are at least trying to, they want to be happy and are at least trying to be a good person. Women have such a tremendous power to help a man, to boost a man, and support a man. And in return, he will adore you for it. When you admire him, it makes him feel more confident.
Yes.
Like, I can do this. I am worthwhile. I am not a loser. And sometimes we get into this sort of almost a blue funk of looking for, oh yeah, he did that wrong. He threw his socks there. Yeah, you can get into you can kind of learn to really enjoy it. And so you find it's more of a habit. And when it's a habit, you think, why didn't I have this long ago? It's okay, as long as you learn it, because none of us are perfect. And this is actually not very difficult to do. As you get the results of it, and we're talking about results, not like I'm doing it to get him to change results.
Right.
But you're doing it to see him happier, more confident. And the natural byproduct, he'll trust you more.
Yeah.
I've read so many success stories from women. All the ones my mother kept. She, in her day, people wrote to her hard letters, and so she saved them in a big box. And the ones where men, when a woman begins to admire things that you think, why didn't she admire that before? The shape of his hands, or the way he lifted something, or how when he described something in work, how he handled another person.
Mm.
And there's hundreds of things to admire. If you like the way he walks, his gait, anything like that, like he feels like she gets me. She understands me. We're sort of the same. When you feel like someone understands you, you feel more relaxed around them. You feel more affectionate towards them. You feel you actually probably do a better job, because as you admire somebody, and in this case, we're focusing on the men in our lives. And when we admire them, and you can do this with your father, your brothers, they actually do better.
Mm-hmm.
They try harder. They do better. And your sons, your children, as you learn to watch the things they do, admire, and say it. A lot of times we notice things and we don't say it. Why we don't is, I don't know for sure, but probably because it makes us feel vulnerable. And we say, you did a, it's not as hard with our kids. We'll say, you did a great job.
Yeah, and a lot of this is just habit. If you're not in the habit of speaking your mind of things when you see, like, you see somebody on the street and you think, wow, that's a really pretty dress, or wow, that woman has beautiful hair. You don't say it. You're not used to just stopping her and saying it. And some women, I think, get into the habit of, well, I'm just not, I just see those things and I don't call them out. But when you realize what it does for him and how...
And for others, you'll be that kind of person that you can totally make someone's day. When you're at the store and you see somebody and you say, those are really cute shoes. I love those. That can kind of make their day.
Yeah.
You never know what people are going through. When you say, you have beautiful hair, like you said, or beautiful eyes.
And if you say it and you're not genuine, the person feels it. No.
Yeah, they feel like, what do you want? Then it becomes creepy.
Yeah. If you see it genuinely.
Specifically. Yeah. Like, I've told women, I really like your nails. It's really beautiful. And then they start kind of going. And it's because it feels good that someone noticed and liked it, especially with the men in our lives. Because I'm absolutely convinced almost no men get enough. They're starving.
Yeah.
And it's free. It's free. You know what? It'll make us happier, too.
That's true.
It's a byproduct.
So this is really great. I think takeaways are number one, it's a major foundation in your relationship.
Mm-hmm.
A huge part of communication and making him feel competent is an absolute key. With repetition, you will find that it comes more naturally. I love that. I think that's really well said. And I hope that this has been helpful for everyone else out there watching. And I think that's all the time we have for today. Thank you so much, Dixie, for sharing all of your
thanks, Cherry.
Advice. And we will see everyone next week.
See you soon. Bye.